The question is why? Why are we here? Why do we exist? What is the purpose in life? We all come from nature itself, right? So what is our position out there? A few theories say we humans are on the top of the food chain, while the others say we don't even exist in this food cycle. We are parasites on Earth. These tiny, tiny creatures, extremely occupied in whatever they are doing. They have got their perfect place in the ecosystem along with their precise work. And it seems like they are completely aware of their purpose in life. For the past few years, I am filming and photographing nature around me in its true form. What I mean by this true form is the reality of today's nature. From the most beautiful moment to the harshest ones. From the most joyful moment till the most painful ones. And to do all that, I have to be in nature most of the time. So apart from editing in a quiet room, I spend most of my time out in nature. With this lifestyle for past few years, now I feel more connected to nature than anything else in the world. It has changed me overall, my thought process, my way of life, and even my diet to an extent. These birds, trees, never asked me about my looks or about the same old shoes. Nature doesn't judge us on our appearance or the wealth we possess. Perhaps I strongly believe that we humans have been judged by nature based on our karmas. We are all an integral part of nature, and we can be an equally important part of this ecosystem. Just that we have forgotten our actual duties in this self-made chaos of ours. Today, I want to share my experience in life with you, what I realized and how I realized about my purpose in life. We all pop up like a blank page. Our parents write the very first words on it. Then our siblings play their role. Later, the whole world tries to teach you something. When my page got completely filled and I was unable to understand what was it all about, I escaped that word around me and tried exploring another one. This is the northeastern corner of India. Their way of life is quite different than what I have seen so far. Perhaps the people are so welcoming and extremely open-hearted. After returning from Northeast, the zeal for exploration never came down, and I was again back on the road. After this journey across India and seeing life from various perspectives, I realized that being content is the key to a happy life. We should respect and value whatever we have instead of craving for more. No matter how different the places and the people are from each other, all of us are completely dependent on natural resources. But what are we giving back? Most of us, nothing. Rather, we are extracting everything possible from all the resources and leaving behind huge carbon footprints. This is our day-to-day routine. Today, it is getting really hard for us to tackle these varied waves of pandemic. It is painful to see what's happening around. How about the pandemic this ecosystem is facing for decades? According to the latest Living Planet report, we have lost around 68% of our biodiversity in the last 50 years. Isn't this painful? Forests here are burning all around every year. Wildlife is going through infections and diseases. Trees are getting chopped and animals are being killed. Plastic and all kind of waste is everywhere. For some people, these are the signs of development. I would call it an ongoing Holocaust. We might be ignoring all this right now, but soon there won't be any way out left. Everyone has to give their bit towards the betterment of nature, which means our betterment as well. I'm using my time and skills in spreading awareness and filming folklore of nature. And through this, if I can bring some positive change in the society's mindset, my existence does make sense. This way, I am trying to live with nature and for nature. And that's my purpose in life.